Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 3, featuring Abbott and Costello, Gale Gordon, Richard Crenna, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
C-A-M-E-L-S.
That's right, folks. C for comedy, A for Abbott, M for Maxwell, E for Ennis, L for Lou Costello. Put them all together and they spell Camel. Experience is the best teacher. Try a Camel. Let your own experience tell you why more people are smoking Camels than ever before. And draw up a chair for tonight's Camel show starring Bud Abbott and Lou Costello.
Costello, come here. Costello, will you come over here, please? Will you listen to me? What are you writing on that pad?
Hey, Abbott.
What are you writing on that pad?
I'm just making out a list of girls I'm going to kiss next week. Here's who I got picked out. Lizzie Schwartz, Maggie Mugglemeyer, Tessie Tinfoil, Lana Turner.
Now, wait a minute. No. Lana Turner wouldn't kiss you.
Oh, no?
Oh, no.
Then I'll scratch her off my list.
I love you. You dummy, always thinking of girls. Girls, girls, girls. Now, great men don't waste their time on girls. Where do you suppose Benjamin Franklin would have been if he'd have thought of girls all of the time?
In the front row at Earl Carroll's?
No. Costello, I've been telling you for the past 3 weeks. You've got to quit chasing girls and get yourself a job. Look at you. Look how sloppy you are. Look at your socks.
I can't help my socks, Abbott. It's those new Hickok plastic garters.
What's the matter with them?
Your socks stay up, but your legs fall down.
Yeah.
Telegram for Luke Costello.
Here, boy.
Out of the way, fatso. I'm looking for Lou Costello.
Boy, he is Lou Costello.
The famous Lou Costello.
Certainly.
The one and only Lou Costello.
Yes.
That's me.
Gee, I listen to you on the radio every Thursday night. You break me up when you say, how do you do?
Wait a minute! Wait a minute!
That ain't me, that's the mad Russian.
You're saying?
I'm a neat.
Who's going to take this telegram?
I'll take it.
It's collect, $14.
He'll take it. Don't give it to me. Here, boy. Hey, Costello. This telegram is from Joe DiMaggio. Listen to this. Dear Lou, as you know, I am recovering from a foot operation. I would appreciate you taking my place on the New York Yankees until I recover. Please report to the Yankee Stadium immediately. Signed, Joe DiMaggio.
Abbott.
Hey, that's
the news. That's the news I've been waiting for. I'm going to be a big league ball player.
Yes.
DiMaggio probably heard about my playing with the Cucamonga Wildcats last year.
You a ball player? I don't believe it, Costello. You know nothing about ball.
Oh, no, I eat baseball. I live baseball. All night when I'm asleep, I dream about baseball.
Don't you ever dream about girls?
What, and miss my turn up at bat?
Oh! That's ridiculous. What's the matter with you?
Yes, and another thing, Abbott. What page are you on?
Never mind what page you're on.
And another thing, Abbott. Not only that, in Paterson, New Jersey, I worked out with a baseball team. I used to stay out till 4 o'clock in the morning.
Why did you stay out till 4 o'clock in the morning?
This was a girls' baseball team.
Costello, if you're going to play with the New York Yankees, you really have to know something about big league baseball, Lou.
I know all about baseball.
All right, suppose there's a left-handed pitcher pitching. What do you do?
I put in a right-handed batter.
Now, suppose there's a right-handed pitcher pitching.
I put in a left-handed batter.
But now I trick you. I take out the right-handed pitcher and put in a left-handed pitcher.
Then I double-cross you. I take out my left-handed batter and put in a right-handed batter.
Now, wait a minute. Where are you getting all those right-handed batters?
The same place where you're getting all those left-handed pitchers.
Oh.
Hello, Bud. Hello, Louis, honey.
It's Marilyn Maxwell.
Hello, Marilyn. I've got great news. I'm going to play ball with the New York Yankees. I'm taking you along as a pitcher.
Oh, now, Costello, Marilyn Maxwell can't pitch.
Oh, no? You should see all the guys she struck out that were trying to get the first base.
No.
This kid has got some nice curves.
Oh, Louis, you're so sweet. But I do hope you'll be careful. You know, big league baseball is a very dangerous game.
Oh, what's dangerous about baseball, Marilyn?
Well, I read in the paper this morning that in the opening game in Boston, 5 players died on base.
Marilyn, you don't seem to know much about baseball. Let me show you how to play indoor baseball. First, I put my left arm around your waist. Then I snuggle my head on your shoulder like this. Then I press my cheek against your cheek.
Oh, wait a minute, Costello. That's not the way to play indoor baseball.
How do you like that? Every season, new rules.
Well, goodbye and good luck, Lewis. I just know you'll become famous with those New York Yankees.
Marilyn's right,
Thank
Costello.
You,
this is your chance to become famous. Now, you've got a good job as a baseball player. And you might find your proper niche in life.
Yes, I might. I mean, after all, if I find my... What will I find?
A niche, a niche. You'll find your niche.
Abbott, when I find an itch, I scratch it.
No. What in the world are you talking about?
An itch. I once had the 7-year itch.
What happened?
I scratched real fast and got rid of it in 3.5 years.
No, I'm not talking about that kind of an itch. I mean an itch in life. A niche in life is what everyone is looking for. Anyone who is successful has found a niche.
Well, if that's the case, I know an Airedale that is doing very well.
Listen to me, Costello. When I say a niche, I don't mean a niche like you have when you have an itch. I mean a niche like you have when you have a notch.
Oh, you don't mean an itch like an itch when you have a niche. You mean an itch like you have when you have a notch.
Now you've got it.
Now I've got it. I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Costello, why do you mash everything up like that? You're the most mixed up man I ever saw.
Well, maybe it's because I fell on my mother's mix master this morning. She had it set for mashed potatoes.
Oh.
I'm all muddled.
I know that. Look, idiot. All I'm trying to tell you is that a niche is a notch. Catch?
Natch.
Natch, all right. Now you know that a niche is a notch. You know that both of them are the same.
Yes.
Now, I could have a notch and you could have a niche.
Yes, niche to me and notch to you.
I'm only trying to impress you the importance of being a big league ball player and having a good income. Did you ever draw a nice big fat salary?
No, I never drew a fat salary, but I once sketched a skinny tomato.
No. Costello, when I say draw, I don't mean draw like you draw when you draw. All I mean draw like you draw when you draw a salary.
Habit, let me smell your breath. Just as I thought. You've drawn one too many already.
Will you listen to me, please? When I say you draw a salary, I mean you draw money.
Now he's got me drawing money. Wait till the FBI finds out about this. I'll probably draw 20 years in a clink. And they don't feed you any celery in there either.
Costello, when I say you draw money, I mean you draw like you draw money to spend it. Not like when you draw on an easel.
That's what I always say. With money, it's easel come, easel go.
No. Everybody draws money. I draw money. I've been drawing money for years. My brother draws money. He's been drawing money for years.
You draw and your brother draws?
Certainly.
Just as I thought. You and your brother are an old pair of drawers.
Experience is the best teacher.
It happened shortly after the end of the war. Two cigarettes glow in the dusk on the veranda of a country house as a man and woman are chatting. The woman remarks,
Robert, you've changed your cigarette brand. This is a Camel. I can tell without even looking.
Yes, I have changed my brand. You know how we smoked whatever cigarettes we could get during the war?
Don't I?
Yes, I must have tried all the brands during that shortage. That's when I found I liked Camels best.
And weren't you right?
Yes, experience is the best teacher. During the wartime shortage, people smoked whatever cigarettes they could get. It was this experience that taught millions the differences in cigarette quality. As smokers tried cigarette after cigarette on their T-zones, that's T for taste and T for throat, it was Camel's rich, full flavor and cool mildness that stood out from all the others. The result?
Today, more people smoke Camels than ever before.
Experience is the best teacher. Try a Camel. And while you light up a Camel, here's Skinny Ennis with Linda.
When I go to sleep, I never count sheep. I count all the charms about Linda. Lately it seems, in all of my dreams, I walk with my arms about Linda. But what good does it do me? For Linda doesn't know I exist. Can't help feeling gloomy. Think of all the loving I've missed. We pass on the street, my heart skips a beat. I say to myself, hello, Linda. If only she'd smile, I'd stop her a while, and then I would get to know Linda. But miracles still happen, and when my lucky star begins to shine, with one lucky break, I'll make Linda mine.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.